Welcome back to Pathologic. It's around 5 p.m. on day 9. There's only about 7 hours left in the day, and unfortunately, it looks like there are many things left to do. So as far as how we're looking on quests, there's 3 side quests at the moment, one of which is complete. The one that's done is the one we just did with Yulia wanting to protect, supposedly anyway, protect Lara. Since Yulia said that Lara planned on assassinating the military guy that just came into town, and Yulia's attempt to protect her was to tell the military guy that Yulia is actually the one that's trying to assassinate him, thus placing her under house arrest. Although honestly, it doesn't seem like she's trying to protect Lara, it seems more like Yulia just wanted around-the-clock house arrest protection. I think she just wanted protection. But there's no way to really be sure. Anyway, that's done. I still have the quest from Anna to give the gun to Lara for the assassination attempt. So I actually have the pistol from Anna, but of course I'm not actually going to give it to Lara, because I kinda want Lara to actually live. And if she has the gun, then I doubt she's going to survive. So I'm just gonna keep it. So this quest is probably gonna go uncompleted. And the other one, which I just got from the Inquisitor back here, is the one to speak to the Haruspex. Yeah, apparently the Haruspex went into the abattoir in search of something. He was supposed to investigate the abattoir for the Inquisitor, I believe, and he has not been heard from since. So she didn't task me with actually going into the abattoir to find him or anything, but she did say that I should ask around about him. So that one is a very vague side quest. No idea exactly what I should do for it, just ask around and hope I can come up with something. So that's one of those quests that's like, okay, I could solve that in 20 minutes, or it might take all day. So no idea about that one. But the main quest for the day is to speak with the children in the polyhedron. Yeah, I've been asked to speak with them both by the Inquisitor herself and also the father of the head child in the polyhedron. The head child being Khan, who is Victor's son. Victor also wanted me to speak with Khan. So 2 people want me to go to the polyhedron. So let's do it. Let's go to the polyhedron and see if we can understand more of its secrets. Also, I just want to point out that as soon as I leave this door, I'm pretty sure the guards are still going to be out there chasing me. So, be prepared. Yep, there they are. Okay. Looks like I managed to ditch 2 or 3 of them, though. Let's see if I can lose these ones going up these crazy steps to the polyhedron. Oh my god, they don't have pathfinding on the bridge! Oh, beautiful. Yeah, they can't even walk on the bridge. Sweet. So we return once again to this bizarre structure constructed out of, like, engineering paper. Such a fascinating structure. Hopefully they'll let me inside. The fortress is off limits. Khan's orders. You carry sand dirt on your snakeskin coat. I brought you important news. Tell us. We will tell the others. Tell him there was a man who needed to get into the agate pit. What the heck is the agate pit? Well, I can either say a thing that sounds kind of convincing, but I don't know what it's really talking about, or I can say the thing that sounds very unconvincing. Let's go with that one. I need to get inside. You will not. The only person we trust is Maria, our sister and patroness. Khan's word. You do not look like her messenger. What proof do you need? Say the password. I want to see the agate pit. Oh, but that was the password? Okay, cool.
Clara will bring Simon back? Those fools. She's aiming for this place.
Bachelor Dankovsky, you were quite eager to examine the polyhedron, weren't you? Indeed I was. I'm ready to negotiate with you now. Well, I don't want to piss him off, so let's not be too aggressive here. I'm ready to hear you out. We need weapons. Okay. Artillery, I presume? Kindly spare me your sarcasm. I need several military rifles. Ammo included, obviously. I've been told they are very long range and very precise. Are you planning to fend off Alexander Block's soldiers with a couple of rifles? Oh, that is his name, Alexander Block! Okay. So when he was called Alexander the Great, that wasn't too far off. His name is actually Alexander. Obviously not. I do have a shred of sense left in me. I'm not going to fight the man who had stormed the Skerries with only 19 casualties on his side. Actually, sorry, that's not casualties, that's... Kazwatlis. 19 Kazwatlis. Oh my god. What a man that Block is. What's your plan, then? If Block finds out there are more than 1,000 of us in here, he'll think twice before storming the place. If he finds out we're armed, it will only take a couple of shots to convince him. Wouldn't you agree? Ah, so they're going to bluff. That they have enough weaponry to outfit all of their 1,000 people. You're going to bluff, aren't you? I am. If you get us the rifles, we'll let you into the polyhedron. Actually, kick it up a notch. We'll show you the boon that fate has granted us in detail. I love this line. Sounds tempting. Bleep bloop bleep bloop. Well, I've processed your request. I'll be back with news. Processing done. Alright, where am I gonna get a couple military rifles? I'm not exactly rich. I've got 20,000 monies, which is a decent amount, but rifles are really expensive, I'm pretty sure. I have one on me, but I'm not willing to part with it, so that means I need a couple fresh rifles, and I probably can't afford it. Hopefully I can do a favor for someone? Maybe? Apparently Khan wants to play soldier. He may be a child, but he speaks in a manner beyond his years. What could he possibly want with five rifles? What? I thought he wanted a couple. Okay, what could he possibly want with five rifles? That's gonna be even harder. I refuse to believe he would be so irresponsible as to exchange fire with the entirety of General Ash's artillery. Regardless, if it is five rifles that will get me inside the tower, then so be it. Wait. General Ash's artillery. Who's Ash? Is his name like Alexander the Ashes Block? Blocky Alexander Ashes? Like, what is his name? I'm just gonna stick with Alexander Block. Huh. That quest has disappointingly no information about how I'm going to procure five rifles. I mean, I guess I could murder those military men that are trying to kill me. They all seem to have rifles. In fact, aren't there five of them? I'm pretty sure there's five of them. Oh my god, are you supposed to kill them? Oh, Jesus Christ. That's gonna make Block try to kill me, right? Isn't that gonna make every single military person in the entire town aggro onto me? I won't be able to survive. I forgot how to leave. Oh, there we go. Right, you just step onto the teleportation pad. Okay, well, I do have enough ammo to kill them. You know, first thing I need to figure out is, are they actually going to drop their rifles? I don't know if an NPC has a weapon, if it's guaranteed to drop the actual weapon. I'm not sure. And I'm supposed to give them ammo as well. Will they all drop enough ammo? Let's test it. I don't intend to actually go with this, even if they do drop the weapons and ammo, but I just want to test it to know whether it's even a viable option. I'm gonna kill one of them and just see if they drop the weapon. And I'm gonna quicksave it before, of course. I guess if I need weapons, the best person to go to would probably be, what's his name? The weird guy in the docks, just, Bad Grief, yeah. Bad Grief. He might be able to procure me some weapons. Okay, let's try this. I think they're down there. Yep. What did that do to my reputation? It actually didn't hurt it that much. Yeah, let's see if they drop it. No, they don't even drop the rifle. Yeah, I can't even pick it up. I can only pick up... I can only pick up a cracker. Which is really weird, because the weapon's obviously just right there. Yeah, this person dropped it. You don't have to, like, highlight the weapon itself, right? I'm pretty sure it's just considered one entity. Yeah, no, this person didn't drop the rifle. Okay, so that's not even gonna work. Well, I'm kind of relieved. I mean, the bad thing is I don't know how to finish this quest, but the good thing is I don't have to do it through a way that I don't like. So, where do I go now? Maybe I should go speak with Victor. Maybe he'd be willing to help out his son. You know what? Maybe the Inquisitor would actually be willing to help him. After all, the Inquisitor doesn't like the military. So maybe she'd be willing to help the kids in the polyhedron. Help out Khan. Yeah, let's go speak with both of them. Why is the music calm? I'm still being chased. Oh, there we go. See if she's willing to help.
Have you met?
Nope. Those other guards are still stuck in this corner here. I saw their head peeking through the stone wall.
Yes?
Ah, I can ask him about the rifles. Good. But first, tell me more about why you need the polyhedron vacated. Right now, it's an optics-based fairground attraction. Akin to a hot air balloon turned into an intricate playground by foolish children unaware of its true potential. It is time to give it the place for which it was intended. And that would be... It's a trap, if you will. A reverberation of mirrors, endlessly reflecting the visage of a lost soul. A great soul, Bachelor. A soul able to encompass the entire world. It's the perfect environment to house a spirit which has lost its physical shell, where it can live and create. Create? The difference between the spirit and the mind lies in the fact that the spirit's creativity requires no outside aids, no tools, no signs, no language. It simply exists, and the glory of its existence spreads upon those who would commune with it. That sounds naive to me. but clearly you don't literally mean what you're saying. On the contrary, that is exactly what I mean. Then I'm not in a position to judge how close your theories are to the truth. What I deem to be the truth is what I have been able to consistently observe. And if what I observe is so uncanny that it could be considered a result of a mental or spiritual illness, I turn to others to vindicate me. I can say something in Latin that I don't understand. I think that's Latin. Didn't mean to offend you with my disbelief. Actually, no, let's say the fancy Latin thing. Let's say something when I don't even know what I'm saying. Let's do it. Oh, okay.
Hopefully they wouldn't attack the polyhedron. They won't dare touch the children, will they? Anina is silent.
Your son intends to make war. He is willing to let me inside, but he is asking for some army rifles. He is asking for some army rifles. He will acquire them, with or without your aid. If you don't help him, your counterparts will. Or someone else. Bring him what he asks, but make him promise not to use the weapons, and not to reveal them to the soldiers until they attempt to climb the tower. And will they make such an attempt? I think they won't. What reason do they have? But it would be better to warn Alexander Block, just in case. Incidentally, have you already talked to him? Yes. What kind of impression did he leave on you? I'm trying to remember my talk with him. It's been so long. Because my original talk with him was literally 3 months ago, in real-world time. So I don't really remember exactly what he was like. Of course, I talked to him a little bit about the whole Laura and Yulia thing, but not enough to kind of remember what kind of a person he really is. Seems to be like he's trying to be a noble and valiant warrior. I believe that he's trying to emulate epic heroes or ancient military leaders. Okay, that ends the conversation.
That does it. I'm gonna break soon.
Okay, so all he told me was, yes, give him the rifles, also tell Block to not go after the children because they have weapons, I guess? He said warn Block. Warn Block about the weapons, I guess? Either way, he didn't actually help me get the rifles. So where the hell am I supposed to get rifles? I'm gonna speak to the other Canes. I know I don't have much time, but they're just right here, so I'm gonna do it. I could really use some information right now, and I need to ask everybody that I can about the Haruspex.
The Dream Party has met the challenge. The polyhedron lives. That much is certain.
Nothing to say to him?
I'm too old. In growing old, we become more foolish and more wise.
Let's go talk with Maria. Aw, oh, come on. More of them are chasing me. Oh, I got a letter. Let's actually read that once I'm inside when it's quieter. I've got battle music going on right now. Yeah, I used to have two on me, now there's three. Okay. The Changeling's Choice. I know you have been told that I am a witch. Not a saint. They may have even told you that I am the sand pest itself, wearing the masquerade of flesh and blood. They certainly must have told you that I save the castaway and condemn the ingenious. They said that I break the courageous and force them to submit to the plague. But let me tell you one thing. saints and miracle workers are always covered in blood and filth. Their acts are not necessarily comprehensible to the common folk, who expect kindness instead of good, and courtesy instead of love. This is not who I am. I know what will happen in 3 days. I will be able to avoid the contradictions that keep you and Haruspex in the dark. Remember, I will perform a miracle in the end. I will perform it with the help of the outcast and the evil. Bad Grief, the thief. Foreman, the villain. Alexander, the cruel. Katerina, the deceived. Lara, the vengeful. Yulia, the unbeliever. Anna, the egotist. Aspidi, the heathen. And Reuben, the oathbreaker. They will survive in order to die, and upon dying, they will claim life everlasting. I need them for the miracle to work. Remember that. Clara. Perhaps this is what people meant when they said certain characters have to remain alive to see something, like something happen, an extra scene or something like that at the end of the game. Because she says she needs them for the miracle to work, so perhaps that's the thing I need to witness. Or that's the thing I want to witness, at least. If I want to witness the miracle, I guess I have to keep them all alive. Okay, well, I'll try to keep them alive. I just worry, though, that one of them perhaps has the plague today, and I just don't even know it. Because how would I know unless I went and visited them, right? But I don't have time to visit everybody, not really. Oh, hey, look at this. even though the Inquisitor didn't say to go look for him, she just said to ask around about Barak. There's actually a mark on the map that says, unless he's left the abattoir, Barak should be somewhere around here. So I guess I am supposed to go over there. Okay. I wonder if doing that could lead to the procurement of the weapons. It's not actually part of the same quest, of course, so I kind of doubt it, but I want to do it anyway. On the other hand, I probably should focus on the main quest. After all, if you don't get the main quest done, you're very screwed. If you don't get the side quests done, it's not necessarily a big deal. But maybe I'll discover something by going over there and talking to people along the way. I don't know. I could... You know what I could do? I could go there. It's a little bit of a longer route, but I could go there by going down here. And going this way, like across the railroad tracks. Up to the termitary and the abattoir. I could go there, and along the way, go to little Vlad's place, talk with him, get the updated plague map. I could visit Aspidi, make sure she's not sick. Although, I think, you know what, I actually cured Aspidi's sickness, like, a couple days ago, I think. So she's probably fine. I doubt she would get sick again. But I could go speak with little Vlad, get the updated map. I could speak to Bad Grief and see if he might know some way to procure some weapons, perhaps. But I'm also supposed to go to the town hall and talk with Block. That's what Victor said to do, talk with Block and warn him about the children. Do you think I can talk Block into just giving me weapons? Hey, watch out, the children have weapons. By the way, can you give me the weapons for the children? Nothing weird about that, right? It's fine. You'll understand. And I could speak with Lara. Not that I have much to talk about, since I'm not giving her the weapon that she wants. Oh boy, what do I do? I think I'm going to do that. I think I'm going to speak with Lara and go to the town hall, speak with Block, and just go east across here, which gives me a shorter route to the termitary and the abattoir. Let's do that. Alright. Let's see if Maria has anything to say, though.
Victoria is no longer Capella. We'll call the girl mistress any day now.
Nope. Oh, they forgot about me for a couple seconds, but then they remembered. They really are annoying. Plague over this way? But this is an old plague district, right? I think it is. Oh, no, it's not an old plague district, never mind. Okay, Lara. To Lara. I'm gonna make a permasave here, actually. Holy crap. Okay, okay, avoid the flames. Need food. I'm actually pretty exhausted, too. Ooh. This is good stuff. Vegetables, yes. Vegetables are good for the money. I don't want any of this other stuff, but I will gladly take the vegetables. Okay. I'm also just gonna go ahead and take the coffee. Oh my god, I'm so close to dead. Look at that. Jesus Christ. I really need to trade for a bandage or something. My god. I might actually die by the end of today just from infection damage. Or I might die from that. Yeah, this is better. Okay, Laura, what am I going to tell you?
There are dark rings under your eyes.
Please, don't be surprised with my strange request. I need a pistol, and it must come with bullets, or whatever it is that they shoot. She really doesn't know what she's getting herself into, does she? She doesn't even know if they shoot bullets. Oh my god. Oh my. Yes, it's bullets. I've asked everybody, even the changeling. You know that tiny pistol she carries around? That looks very handy. It's just what I need. But she wouldn't give it to me. She said she has plans for me, that she requires my life. So your life is what you're going to risk, aren't you? Oh, it's not like you're my husband or older brother, are you now? If you won't bring it to me, I'll just ask the Haruspex. He's less squeamish. And I can give you a very rare and valuable thing in exchange. That thing from yesterday. Remember? Are you saying you have no need of that thing anymore? And why would that be? No, Lara. I need you alive. Don't even think about getting a firearm. Yeah, I'm not gonna give her one. Hell no.
I think I'm fading. My clothes are worn into holes.
I think this is just not really a dialogue tree, but let's check. It's fate. Fate itself has brought him here. I hope you're not talking about me. I want nothing to do with fate. Yeah, nothing. Okay. Nothing to do with Laura, then. Okay. Next stop, Town Hall. Yeah, let's go speak with Block about the children. Can I sneak away from them? Nope. Ah, out of the plague zone. Feels refreshing. Even if I do have three guards trying to smear my brains on the sidewalk. Oh my god, my health is so low. I want to stop and ask children and stuff to trade and crazy guys to trade for bandages, but I'm kind of scared to stop.
Whose will was it that sent us to this plague-ridden hellhole? We're needed at the front line.
Oh my god, I can actually ask him for rifles. Isn't that gonna make him suspicious? Okay. Need a few rifles. Please don't ask questions. What for? Personal needs? No, I do not understand. What kind of needs?
Don't you trust me?
Perhaps I could make an exception and issue firearms to a civilian, but in order to do so, I need to know exactly what they're going to be used for. Oh my god, I can tell them that they're for the boys. That's not a good idea, is it? Surely he's not going to believe that I want them for self-defense, though, right? After all, why would I need 5 rifles for self-defense? Do I have 5 arms? Well, he's sure as hell not gonna believe the self-defense thing, so let's see where this leads. They're for the boys. They're asking for rifles. Do not joke like that again, Bachelor Dankovsky. But I'm not joking. Enough. Let us not return to the subject again. Oh, shit. Out of curiosity, what happens if you tell him the other thing? What if you tell them they're for self-defense? Like, I'm almost certain that's not gonna work, but I'm curious. Need some rifles, personal needs, okay, self-defense. For self-defense, I'm willing, out of deepest respect, to issue 1 rifle and 3 clips to you personally. Oh. Okay, so yeah, he doesn't give me 5 rifles, which is not surprising, but he will give me something. I mean, normally I don't like to reload my game and do really cheesy stuff, but honestly, I feel like I'm already at such a huge disadvantage with the time and everything, and he's only giving me 1 rifle and I still need 4 more, so you know what? Between that, the lack of time, the fact that this is 1/5 of what I need, and the fact that I haven't played this game for like 3 months, I'm gonna take it.
May I have 2 rifles?
Are you hiding something from me? No. In any case, I can't do 2. That is a pity. Oh, thank god, at least I've got 1. Okay, it's stump a lockpick, I guess. I don't need a million lockpicks.
I'm gonna break some.
There we go. And it's at durability 100%. Sweet. My old one was at 84%. Perhaps I can give the children the crappier rifles. Okay, 1 out of 5. Where do I get the other 4? Oh god, fuck, I forgot about them. Okay, let's not get killed by the guards this time. However, before I even step foot outside, I do kind of need to decide where I want to go. I don't have any solid leads on where to get the other rifles. The only other quest that I can do that I actually want to do is the side quest with Brock. So perhaps I should just go to the termitary and search for Brock and see if that might lead to something good. It's worth a shot, right? I mean, if I don't do that, I'm just gonna have to ask random people and hope that they can help me. Like, maybe the old Gimskis can give me rifles. Perhaps Bad Grief can help me with rifles. Maybe little Vlad could help me. But that's just guessing. Yeah, alright, let's go search for Brock, I guess. Also, keep a close eye out for anybody who I can trade with, because I am literally about to die. You can see a couple pixels of my health bar and that's it. I really need to find somebody to trade bandages with. Like, super bad. Child! Oh, that's a terrible idea. That was so stupid. I was like, oh, child, I can trade with them, but then I realized, oh, children don't have bandages, right? They just have weapons and stuff, and medicine. So then I went back, and then I died. Okay, let's try that again. Oh, the chalice actually right here. All right, well, I can stop for a second. I think. Medicine. What medicines do I actually have? I think I actually need more Meridorm. I think I'm good on antibiotics. Yeah, I've got antibiotics, but I do need more Meridorm. Okay, each one of those costs 2. That's worth 5. It's worth 1. Yeah, here we go. Whew! I'm sure I almost died there. Alright. Keep going straight. There is food around here. I should probably just stop at a freaking hospital, honestly, and buy a bandage. It's not exactly as efficient, but at this point I don't think I have much of a choice, because I think I will literally drop dead any minute. What's food and what's a hospital? I know this is food and I think that's food. I don't know about these three. What about this one up here on the right? Sorry. Oh. Oh god. Oh my god, that's how little health I have? I just died, didn't I, from my health just passively going down. Shit. Shit. I think I'm screwed. I think I have to load an old save game and find a hospital. Oh right, if you open your inventory, that doesn't pause. Okay. I'm gonna load an old save and find a hospital. Be right back. Oh, here's a hospital. Okay. Of course they don't sell bandages, oh my god. They sell tourniquets, which I'm pretty sure are just the worst garbage. Pretty sure they barely heal. Let's see. I died while using a tourniquet. Oh, fuck my life. Okay, here we go. So, yeah, just to quickly catch you up on what I did, it took like 6 saves or so, but I finally managed to make it to the medical place. Most of the times I died while getting there. One time I got there, and apparently the inventory of the store owner is actually randomized because I got there and they didn't even have any tourniquets or bandages. So I was like, okay, well, that's great. But then finally I went back there, I bought 2 tourniquets, which is ridiculously expensive, and it healed me a total of like 20% of my health. Oh, what a waste of money. But yeah, at least I'm alive for now, and I'm desperately hoping I can find somebody to trade water for bandages with. Also, this guy's gonna try to kill me. Oh no, oh no, oh no, no, no! Fuck! He decided to throw it at me. That's unavoidable unless you're far away. I think I'm gonna have to kill him. If only the guards would do their damn job and attack the thief instead of the person who did nothing wrong to them. Really, what is wrong with those guards? I mean, come on. Yeah, I think I'm gonna have to kill him. Oh god, my rifle's not selected! Are you kidding me? My rifle's not selected! Fine, I'm going inside of this building. This is a wonderful building, it's very beautiful. There's a ninja, goodbye. Alright, there we go. Oh boy, let's get to the termitary. Where can I cut across? There's a place here where I can cut across, but I don't remember where. Dead end. Dead end. Fuck, where is it? Might have already passed it. Oh, here we go. Oh, cool. Another murderer. Alright, at least I'm far enough away. Yeah, okay, here we go. Almost there. Come on, guys! There's a murderer behind you, please. Yes, yes, kill him. Okay, what the hell is that? Oh, that's the sound of the flamethrower, guys. Termitary is accessed from back here, I think? think it's from back here. There's food over there. Do I need food? Yeah, I kinda do. Please tell me this is the right door. Yes, good. What is efficient? I know vegetables are good. Dried fish is good. Dried meat? I think dried meat's okay. What about bread? You know what? I'm gonna take all of it. Pretty sure that's all decent food. Alright, don't need to worry about my hunger for quite a while. How's my money doing? Low. 12,000. Yeah, termitary can be accessed from in here. Come on, Barak, please be alive and please have something good for me. Which entrance? This one? Yeah. Oh, let's equip my weapon. There we go. Okay. So Barak is supposed to be somewhere around here. Unless he's left to the abattoir. If he has, well, I'm dead. Because I don't have time to search for him, but anyway, last time I saw him, he was back here. Of course he's not here. Well, that means there's only about 2,000 more places to search, but chances are the best thing to do is probably go speak with Taya. She's, after all, the head person here. Perhaps she can tell me something. And the question is, can I remember where she is? she's one from the highest floor, I think. Actually, you know what? I do remember where she is. Yeah, she's down this hallway. I remember it was the hallway of all the torches. I feel like my health is going down fast. Is it my infection? I guess my infection's relatively high. My immunity's not great either. Let's take the last Twirite extract. Okay. Twirite extract kills you. Gotcha. Alright, please, please, Taya, have information for me.
I see everything.
No! She doesn't have anything for me. Oh, God. Okay, I'm gonna go search this whole place for Barak. I'll be right back. Okay, thank God Barak is actually inside of here. Yeah, he's on the second floor. Second floor, right in here. I remember this place. I've been here once before. That's where that, like, illegal panacea operation was happening.
What?
It's nice to see that you survived, Onion. Barely, I'm just about to keel over. Yesterday, they attacked me like wild beasts. They are wild beasts. Be careful with butchers, Bachelor. Life around here is different. A single person means nothing, not by himself. You aren't worth a kopeck if you are estranged from the whole. I'll keep that in mind.
What was that?
Aglaya Lilich has lost track of you. She asked me to tell you that she was worried. I have nothing to offer her for now. Tell her that I have descended underground. I've met with Foreman Oyen. So far, he refuses to tell me what I want to hear. I don't like his riddles and half-truths. I have a suspicion that he's a villain. I have no idea who Foreman Oyen is. Are you going to go there again? Yes, of course. Through that abyss lies my only way back. Can you find something out for me? This is very important because, obviously, I won't ever get inside. Do you need that to beat the epidemic? They told me that was the reason you went underground yesterday. That's right. Then speak, Onion. In this, we are on the same side. Which one to go with? The abattoir has underground passageways which could explain the origin of the disease. Or I'm sure that these bacteria have a mineral origin. Let's go with that one. A friend told me that the abattoir has underground passageways, which could explain the origin of the disease. Now that is curious. Underground passageways. The local soil has rather unusual structure. The earth has something akin to an internal crust. Even water can't pass through it. Why? This means the disease is dissolved in the ground. Everywhere? Under our feet? No, Vlad the Younger claims otherwise. I suspect that there is a sort of shaft or cavern under one of the buildings here. Some spot where this filth has built up. I see. I'll find out what I can, Onion. Your words have guided me to an interesting idea. Good. Okay, I feel good about this. I hope to see you shortly. Let's see what that's done to the quest. Does that finish it? No, it doesn't finish the quest for the day, actually. Herospex is determined to carry on. He wants to be left alone and says he will notify me himself. All for the best. I'd rather return to my own research, without him prowling around. Why did he give the Inquisitor the attitude, though? Would he be as daring if she was stood right there next to him? Yeah, I guess he'll probably send me a letter later today with the results. Okay, well, that's very cool. Like, I'm glad I did that, because that's obviously a very important thing for the story. And for my main quest of finding out the origin of the disease and trying to stop it. But for my quest for today, that doesn't help even in the slightest bit. I still need 4 weapons. It's still... what time is it? God. It's almost 8 o'clock. Which means I have about 4 hours left in the entire day, and I need 4 rifles. And I need to deliver them to the children all the way across the map. What in the hell? How am I gonna do that? As far as I can tell, I'm out of ideas. I'm out of any concrete leads other than simply asking random people. Asking Aspidy, Bad Grief, Vlad the Younger, the Olgimskis, perhaps. This feels bad. I don't feel even remotely in a comfortable place. I mean, I never really am, but I feel particularly uncomfortable here because my health is garbage, my infection's kinda high, I need to sleep, I need to eat. Oh, actually, no, I don't need to eat. But I need everything else. I need health, and I need sleep, and I need to take medication for the infection, but I can't take that because it'll kill me, since I'm so low on health. And I need to finish the day's quest, and I have little time left to do it and no solid leads. This feels pretty bad. So, I hope you've enjoyed so far. And when I return, I'm going to start a desperate search for the remaining 4 weapons that I need for the children by probably going across the train tracks here to the west and speaking with the people that I haven't spoken to today and seeing if they can perhaps help me. Probably speak with Grace, Aspidy, Bad Grief, and Little Vlad. And hopefully I'll find something.